everyone, and welcome back to my channel. It is Yvetta, the owner of Yvetta Made It Graphics and Marketing. If you are new here, and a lot of y'all are new here, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and join the Made It crew. Okay, so as you can tell by the title of this video, we are doing a Grinch theme template in Canva. So I got the idea from Imani Unleashed on Instagram. That is also her name on TikTok as well. I love, 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 love her work. She has Canva classes, and she posts a lot of her work that she does in Canva, and it is amazing. Anyway, she posted a 25 days challenge of, wait, hold on. She posted a Canvas 25 days of design challenge. Okay, so on each one of the different days, she has like different challenges that you can do in Canva. I saw the Grinch one, and I was gonna do a Grinch flyer anyway because of her. So I was like, okay, let me kind of join in on this challenge and do this one. So y'all be sure to follow her and check her out. I will put the flyer on the screen somewhere so that you all can see it. But let's get right into it. Okay, so this is Grinch inspired, so I have my Grinch right here. I did just Google Grinch, the Grinch or whatever, but I will put the link to this specific photo in the description. It is free, so if I don't remember to put it in there, y'all make sure you let me know and I will get that for you all. But let's get started. Okay, so my idea of the flyer was to do a like a brow flyer, because y'all seen the Grinch eyebrows. I love him, but baby, it looks a mess. Okay, so I want to do a pink theme, I guess. I think y'all know I will go back and change something. But as of right now, I want the background to be pink. And then I want to grab my gradient, which is in here somewhere, and do like a spotlight type of thing. So this is the gradient that I think I'm going to use. I'm going to put the name up if it comes up. It's called Orange Blur Circle Illustration. If you type that in, you'll be able to find it. I do recommend starring the elements that you plan on using so that you can find them quickly and reuse them more. This is a free element. A lot of people ask all the time, do I use the free version of Canva? And it's like, are you new here? No, I pay for Canva. I feel like it's worth however much it is. $10, $12? I don't know. It's worth it because, one, I use it to make the templates on my website, and two, I just think it's worth it because, I mean, it's gonna get used regardless, so I pay for it. Anywho, let's go ahead and grab the Grinch so I can see how I want to place them on the flyer. Of course, you have your guides that let you know that your elements are lined up correctly, but you can also come up here into the position and just center it or align it wherever you want to. Centered is blurred out because I already have the Grinch centered. I did find a new font, and I'm in love with this font. Alright, so this is part of the text that we're going to add to the flyer, and I'm going to show y'all the font. Not that. Boom. Y'all look at this font. If I don't do nothing else, I'm going to find a font, okay? So the font is called Grinched. I did get it from thefont.com. Of course, you could just Google the name. It'll come up. But I will put the link in the description so that you all can download it as well for your flyers. Okay, so Grinch themed flyer. I'm gonna put "Don't be a Grinch." I kind of want to curve the text, and the way that you do that, you just highlight the text, hit effects, and then you have the curve option down here. Why did I do that? All right, let's try that again. I think 36 is, yeah. I'm probably gonna make this like really small. Ooh. Okay, maybe like that. Y'all will see me move stuff around a lot because I don't know how I be wanting stuff. And then I'll see something else and I'll be like, okay, let's do that. I kind of want him bigger, but not like hanging off the flyer. But that could possibly change. Okay, so right here, let's talk about it. When you zoom in, start over. I zoomed in because I want y'all to see this straight line. A lot of people leave their flyers like this. I hate it. Stop doing this. I'm gonna show you how to cover it up. One way you can cover it up is just by putting the picture wherever the cutoff part is, just put that on the end of the flyer. Another way is to fade it out, and I'm gonna show you a few ways. One way is to use that same gradient, which is why I said to start, because you're gonna use it. See, right here is orange. We're just gonna make it pink. And look. Ooh. if I can, okay, this don't want to move, so yeah, but all you have to do is just place it right on that line and duplicate it a few times. Look, y'all, can't even see it, just duplicate it. And if you have to move the picture, which you're probably gonna have to do to adjust it or whatever, all you have to do is select all of the gradients. Y'all, I'm pointing at the computer screen like y'all can see me. Select all the gradients in the picture and group it. Then watch, it moves with it. Period. Game changer. Okay, so I'm going to delete some of these because I didn't place them right. But that was just to show y'all what you can do. I'm gonna bring that one to the front because for some reason it's not in the front. But I'm just gonna fix this right quick and then we shall continue. Now I kind of like the word being behind him. This is why it takes so long for me. Like, I can do flyers in 2 minutes. But once I start moving stuff around and yeah, it turns into a whole different thing. Okay. I don't want his hair to be like hanging off. Oh no, I'm probably gonna move it again anyways. Don't be a Grinch. Book your brow appointments. So I need more text. But it's, of course, it's gonna be smaller than the main text of the flyer, but we're just gonna do book your brow appointment. Okay, book your brow appointment, lash appointment, whatever you're going for with your flyer. Okay, so it is centered, but it's too big. I'm probably gonna move it down just a little. Okay, so I don't know what color I want any of this to be, so I'm probably gonna try to keep it like really, really simple. Simple, simple, simple. I kind of want to keep it black or white. Maybe white. I don't know. So I had plans to add like the image of Whoville in the background, but I don't know if I want it on here anymore. Just like half. Is that half? Let me see. Whoa, that was nowhere near half. Alright, so I got this layer locked, so I need to unlock it so I can move it all the way back. Like this. What I'm going to do is just turn down the transparency a little bit. I don't know, I guess it gives it a little bit of something. But as you can see, we do have that straight line. And I have another way to get rid of it. You can use that same gradient that we used for the Grinch. Or you can use one of these. I have this one right here. This one right here is one color. It goes straight from that color to transparent. So if I were to change it to pink and just put it right where that line is. Like that. It just goes straight to transparent, so you can't see it. But there is another one that I use. Oh wait, did I tell y'all the name of it? Gradient that fades to transparent. So like when you search for stuff on Canva, literally type exactly what you're looking for. This is the other gradient. For this one you can change two colors. Like it's purple and white now. So I'm just gonna change the purple part to pink. And this one has like a white at the top. So as you can see, it's over everything. It's making everything have like a white overlay. We don't want that. So I'm just gonna place it where that line is again and move it to the back. Not all the way to the back, but like right there. And now you can't see the line and it has the white overlay. It depends on what you're working on as far as which one you should use. Because a lot of times I hate for that white overlay to be on anything. But anyways, okay. Book your brow appointment. I want a rectangle around it to make it look like a button or something like that. So I'm just going to hit R on the keyboard and line it up to where it's around the text. To make sure it's centered, you just select the box. Grinch just wants to be in the way today and I don't understand. Okay, select the box, select the text, go to position, center, middle, boom. Okay, I'm gonna have to do that again because I like to round off the edges of my boxes. So what I'm gonna do is just come right here to border style. Border weight makes it thicker, and then corner rounder rounds the corners of the box. Boom. Okay, so this is not the color that I want any of this to be. So let me get that fixed. I really did not plan out the colors. If you watch my other videos, we usually plan out the colors that we want everything to be before doing this. I didn't do that this time. This was a spur of the moment flyer design. Okay, so see how the button kind of looks flat or whatever on here. What I'm gonna do is, why is all this extra stuff happening today? Okay. The box looks flat, so what I'm gonna do is turn it into a PNG That way I can add a shadow to it. And to do that, I'm just going to drag it down here to this other page. Make it not that big. Let's see. Keep it consistent. Okay. So what I'm going to do is share, download it as a transparent background, just the second page. And once it downloads, I'm going to upload it back into Canva and then add a shadow to it. So it's right there. I'm just going to upload it, get rid of this page. All right, so now we have the button here. I'm going to make this box smaller. Personal preference, but I just hate clicking on, like, if I'm trying to move something else, that big old box is going to be in the way. All right, so edit image, go to shadows, and I'm going to add a glow. See how that makes a shadow around the box. You can turn the transparency up and down. You can remove the blur. It's whatever. However you want it to look. I do love a blur, okay? I love a blur. So I think that's the sizing that I want it to be. All right, so now that I have the button, I'm just gonna put it like that. Book your brow appointment. Okay, and now I'm gonna add like the caution tape type of thing. Yeah, I know what I'm talking about. But it's just like rectangles and you put your text across it, like caution, caution, caution. I don't know how long I want them to be, so I'm just gonna go ahead and make them long. And I wanna do one black, I think, and one pink. So this is the black one. I'm going to duplicate this text that I have down here. And just place it across that rectangle. And what I'm going to type is just slots available. And duplicate it a couple times. I'm going to select everything and group it so that when I move it, it all moves together like that. And I'm just going to position it however behind the Grinch. Y'all know what went missing? My gradient that was behind him. So I'm going to fix that in just a second. All right, so that's one, and I'm gonna go ahead and duplicate this whole thing if it lets me. All right, so here's our second one. All I'm gonna do is make this pink maybe a darker shade of pink. Ooh, I don't know if I want this text black or white. I think I'm gonna do black, but that could change. Okay, so now we have our caution tape. I'm gonna group those together and then group these together again and then move them. Oh, yeah, I done grouped the whole thing together. Oh my word. Okay, group this one. And then group this one. And then I'm just going to place them how I want them. So what I'm going to do is duplicate these and put some down here. What's the pink's on the top of on that one, so I'm gonna put the pink on the bottom of this one. I actually like it with just one. What did I say? Oh, the black one's supposed to be at the top. Okay, so I like how that one is lined up. I don't know why I don't like how this top one is, but oh my goodness. I just don't like it. I don't understand. Okay, you get the idea. I'm going to go ahead and fix that gradient since I have the folder right here now. And just put it behind all of this stuff, which is why I did it first, so I wouldn't have to do all of that. But okay. Don't be a Grinch, book your brow appointment. Okay, so that's pretty much it. But I wanna go ahead and add like my little details and stuff. I'm starting to like these little whatever they are. Let's see what they're called in case you want them. Oh yeah, we did this last time. I'm not trying to pronounce that. I'm not gonna do it. So hopefully you can see it. I'm not about to try to say that word, but it's a transparent overlay and it just adds a little to the flyer. Okay, see, like I'm just gonna do two right there, and then I have some other stuff. I have quite a bit of stuff, but I don't know. I've seen everybody use this plastic and I want to use it for something, but I don't think this is the thing to use it on. I did use it on the Barbie box tutorial though, if you have not seen that one. I think I want to add a little sparkle. So not this folder, this folder. I'm going to find my little sparkles that I added. That's one thing with Canva. If you do have a free version, you can literally add whatever elements that aren't free. You can add them to Canva. Like, I know for a long time, when I first got Canva, I didn't have the iPhone. Like, Canva has iPhone. I think they have free ones now, but they didn't have like the realistic looking iPhones for free. I used to just go on Google and find one and just add it. Like, you don't have to pay for Canva, but you have to do extra work to find the good stuff. Like, you can find it on Google, but you literally have to go find it, download it, then put it in Canva, and it's a lot. Did this flyer need sparkles? No. Did I do it anyway? Yes. Oh, not that. It's supposed to go in the middle of the thing. Okay. I like this. Ooh. It's like a really simple flyer. I like simple but cute flyers. Like, you really do not have to put all of that extra stuff on your flyers. Do I have the extra stuff? Yes. But that doesn't mean you have to use it. There is, oh, here it is, my light flare. I have to use this on everything. It's so small, but so necessary. Now, I feel like we're growing out of the You know how people used to put like the diamonds on all of their stuff? Like these, where are they? And it's crazy. Okay, so these, the girls used to put this on everything, and it used to be like right here. And I know y'all know what I'm talking about. It took me forever to find diamonds that I could actually use. Like any ones that I would use, they'll have like a weird background and I couldn't erase the background. This and that, da, da, da. When I finally started using them, I was like, this really is not cute. Like, I don't want this. And it's crazy. Like, we grow out of the glitter and all that other stuff. But anyways, this is my Grinch-inspired flyer. I hope you all enjoyed this video. Y'all know, DM me on Instagram if you recreate this. Don't forget to check out Imani's challenge. I think it's going to be, like, really fun. But I will see y'all in the next one. Bye.